problem. Okay.
What song shall I play?
Hold the phone, folks. A redone version of Storytime Episode 4 will be uploaded shortly. Just need to find a perfect song.
Eddie Grant? Can you play?
Hey, what's going on, everybody? Dill Murray here, and welcome back to a redone version of Storytime Episode 4, where instead of talking about my sportsman script, which I honestly thought that some of the content I used in that video could probably piss a lot of questions off. So, I'm gonna talk about something different. It was back in March where our school started to set up a spaghetti dinner, which explained two pointless fundraisers where we sat at a table handing out tickets to people walking by. Can anyone say Snooze Fest?
Don't know.
I'm thinking. So then fast forward to March for spring break or Pi Day. Yeah, all the math geeks in the world can rejoice because of Pi Day. So, after sitting through a pointless day of Pi-themed activities, where a snitch almost got me and my friends in trouble, hint, hint, wink, wink, and after watching Dude Perfect, and watching a little bit of Smitty practice when I got home and got changed, we went to spaghetti dinner. If you're wondering, the theme was red, white, and blue. So, yeah. So this is the period where I was hurt and couldn't run. So I was an idiot and decided to take my scooter down. That thing hidden behind my door. If you know what I mean. So then I ride down to school and went in, checked in with the lady running it, and see where she wanted me. I don't remember much, so basically I went into this room. Apparently they ordered Olive Garden, and I just grabbed some pizza, and I'm thinking, everybody's dressed up in red, white, and blue. Oh, the American jokes I can make. But I'm not going to joke about America, because this country is the greatest. They give me rights for me to record YouTube. Unlike you people in the Middle East. So. So. Then after a while, I Have my pizza. Chug my medium shot sized glass of Pepsi. And just went to the old gift thing. So they were holding a silent auction. And apparently there were a bunch of other people there. Oh, dear God. Where's the Jeopardy theme song? The whole time you just stood there for an hour find where the crap goes. If you know what I mean. Okay, that's creepy. Basically just played for about an hour, I played Find Where the Crap Goes. Yeah, that's fun. So the Jeopardy thing felt like Let Me Go by Hooters now. Pretty damn good song. So let's play this all again. After a while I got that and I just went to the teacher's lounge where they were, when they looked like they ate enough pie to end world hunger. I'm not kidding. I walked in there and there's a table and apparently some star was already working on it. I'm not giving any names, but I was down there and I'm thinking, so we're gonna play the sort of pie out. Oh, they warned me people were OCD about pie. After going back to my friend, she was, my one wanted to, she was there too. I pulled my friend back to the teaching lounge. Yeah, I get there, she's like, turn around, and I'm like, fuck, you do realize that fucking hurt, right? Yeah. If you know what I mean. So then I get back to the pie room, where we play the sword and the pie. For the record, if you're OCD, that's great, but sometimes it pisses people off, like me. But no, I want this pie here, and this pie here, and this pie here. Good God! Make up your fucking mind! So I made it back to my post where there's this one cookie that got really nice for me, it's actually really pretty. And I was only one time, so guess where I spent most of the night? Behind that table. Serving coffee. So I sit down, question height. You lost it the entire time on the board, because that's why you went up the way that you're sitting. Because my legs cramped up. Now, if you don't know, as night went on and people started asking, but there was this one chick came up really pretty, probably about my height, my age, literally, my birthday's about 24 hours plus from me. Her birthday fell at 24 hours plus from mine. I'm thinking, what if I'm dead? Nothing. I pulled a 12-inch string to see what my dad member does. He's like, hey, how can I help you? I'm Bill Miller. What do you do? And he's like, okay, want me to bring this up here? Or you got it. He's like, oh yeah, okay. Okay, I'll put it up. And then my mom gave me a book, and my friend was standing right there, ironically, and I'm thinking, nice salesperson act. I'm thinking, so what? She thought. But at the same time, I'm thinking, get off my shit. Just get off my shit. I didn't want to say that because there are a lot of people who are PC. And I mean PC to the extreme. Like, Ned Flanders PC. If you know what I mean. Some of you that work spaghetti during your prime schooling is what I'm talking about. When I rolled up to school, Gretchen, rode up and almost crashed. So after a while, I don't know what came over me, but I started feeling shit. So I played run back and forth to the third grade, fourth grade bathroom. Yay! After a while, my band slash leadership teacher slash the asshole decided to have the latest button choir sing. Quote unquote, out-of-tune piece of shit choir. When he is together, so, after a while, running back and forth, I just, realized that eventually, since a lot of the parents that were there were, coffee drinkers, we ran out of coffee filters. So luckily, someone who was lucky enough to run out to the 7-Eleven and stock up on those coffee filters to keep a small 7-year-old up all night. Nice! There's this one kid there who, was fluffy for his age. That's all I'm gonna say. I'm thinking, I need coffee. And he's like, no. Who's this for? My parents. I'm thinking, because this smirk on his face has got the smirk of, hey, I'm gonna bounce off the walls all around. I'm thinking, no. No. Oh, you don't deserve coffee, kid. Nothing personal, but I'm pretty sure your parents don't want to see you bouncing off the fucking wall. And I'm pretty sure I don't want to see you bouncing off the wall. He's like, no, coffee slows me down. I'm thinking, bullshit. And I'm thinking, fire, bullshit. So the whole time, since there were a lot of beautiful women there that were around my age, it just felt like, if I'm lucky, you might be taking one of these bitches home. I had like the smiley face, because there's this one chick walked by and she looked pretty good. I'm thinking, in fact, I could explain this, but it probably turned into a porno and it'd be way too hot for YouTube. So after a while, my dad showed up and I'm thinking, oh, cool. I can actually rest and not infect everyone with the bullet or whatever. I'll say that. Cool. of all time. I could let Pitbull explain it. His be turned into a Latin erotic poem, if you know what I mean. I'm gonna find more songs here. And the whole time, I'm standing there, face plant, someone told me, because I felt like this. Basically, everyone was in red, white, and blue, so she started matching same face, you know. We're going to DC, so the American capital of the world. So, then I rode home, so I didn't enjoy it. I don't want to be my stupid there on the night, so. So, I went to my office, got my shades, and then went straight outside with my iPod in hand, with this song playing, and rode home. Question. Rode home, really fast in the soccer field, got back up, rode down the street at such force that I almost stopped in the electric box, and made it home. Meanwhile, back at the school, more OCD people about to fly, nothing. With your laptop, you got to so I can shove it in your face? You're an asshole. Nothing personal. People, if you're OCD about something, that's great, but you're taking it to a different extreme about everything, then it becomes a question. You can never move. Yeah, if you're OCD about something, I honestly don't have a problem with it. Everybody is. But if you're OCD about every little thing, like that song and like that Latin Rift song. Okay, back to what I think, though. That's OCD, and there's a lot of stuff in the intro. So it's the next time you hear that these shows are going to be acceptable. There are so many fine women here. And I mean, fine women. I could explain it, but it'd probably turn into a porno. I could let Pitbull explain it, and that just wouldn't make any sense. Or I could let Andy Samberg explain it.
Hang on, please.
No need here for the silly games. Make our way through the smoking crowd. The club in the sky and ammonia cloud. Moving close as the laces fly. Our bodies touch and angels cry. Leave this place, go back to yours. Our lips first touch outside your doors. The whole night what we've got in store. Whisper in my ear that you want some more. And I is in my pants. This really never happens, you can take my word. I want to apologize, that's just absurd. Mainly your fault for the way that you dance. And now I is in my pants. Don't tell your friends or I'll say you're a slut.
I'm going to go volunteer to the St. Paul's Foundation.
In my pants, I just stayed a great man, I shit in my
Some of you are probably going to look at me as a sicko for this, but... Men seeing a girl in shorts makes them want it. Makes them want to jizz! Makes them want to... Nothing personal, but seeing a man... A girl seeing a man seeing a girl in shorts, especially short shorts, makes... Especially shorts, makes them want to go. Makes us want to... Wait for it. My pants! Okay. So, that was the spaghetti dinner. I don't remember how much we raised, but apparently if we ran out, we were going to get pizza. I don't know why, but hey, school logic, they organized this, not me. So, yeah. There's an important update about stop motions. Tune in tomorrow at about 10 o'clock east, 10 o'clock mountain time for an important update regarding signups and the first race. Like this, please like this video if you enjoyed. Comment on this video if you want to. And every comment and like means a lot, by the way. And subscribe to Dylan Merway. One subscriber away from doing that Q&A. And, oh yeah, I got a lot planned for you. Instead of doing a regular Q&A, I'm going to live stream it. Yeah. It's going to be that good. And follow me on Instagram. Follow me on Google+. And subscribe to Dylan Merway. And have an awesome night, everybody. Be sure to check in at 10 o'clock Mountain Time tomorrow for an important update regarding stop motion signups and the first race.